joined now Paul Callen, former prosecutor and CNN legal analyst, and John Dean, former Nixon White House counsel and CNN contributor. Paul, Stormy Daniels' attorney, Michael Avenatti, responding, saying, our case just got that much better. We very much look forward to testing the truthfulness of Mr. Trump's feigned lack of knowledge concerning the $130,000 payment, as he stated on Air Force One. As history teaches us, it is one thing to deceive the press and quite another to do so under oath. Your reaction?
Well, there's nothing new in Avenatti's statement. He's been saying that for a while, but he has a federal judge who's warned him not to bring a motion for an expedited deposition of the president into court unless there's something else that happens, a motion to compel arbitration, and that has not happened. So I think you're not going to see anything happen with Avenatti, at least in the next few days.
So, John, what do you think, though, about this fundamental point, right, that the crucial thing that happened tonight was that the president answered the question? That has not happened before, all right? That's been the whole thing for 3 months. He has not said anything. Now he has come out and said something. Do you think he's telling the truth?
It's very suspect that he's telling the truth. I think he didn't want to respond to a question. He got forced into answering, saying something, so he had little choice. But, you know, Aaron, he's handled this whole thing differently than most of his perceived enemies, where he goes after them and he's on the offense. Here, yep, he's been solely on the defense, and I keep wondering what else is larger for him in this issue. Does he have some sort of prenuptial that's at risk? Does he have some sort of postnuptial that's at risk? I don't know. I think something else is going on here, and he's very defensive on this one.
Yeah, I mean, certainly he has never come out aggressively against her as he has with other women who have accused him of unwanted sexual assault or advances. Obviously, Stormy Daniels had said this was consensual. The crucial question here, though, Paul, is that, you know, the reason that this whole situation matters, there's multiple reasons, putting aside the ethics and the character of the President of the United States. Was there a violation of Federal Election Commission law with money to pay someone off and influence the election? And there's the risk with the precedent of Bill Clinton of whether the President of the United States could be called under oath and caught for lying on this.
Oh.
Does it matter that now he's actually come out and spoken, right? Now he has said something. Now, it was to the press, but he has said something.
Yes, he has. And I think what we're seeing is the defense was kind of laid out by Michael Cohen at the beginning, which is, this is my money. I paid the money. It wasn't the president who paid the money. And I think that what he's setting up here is the defense that Michael Cohen was kind of given general authority to settle cases and deal with women who may have these sorts of allegations against him. I'm betting Cohen knows where a lot of skeletons are buried.
Certainly.
And all of that may come out if the president has to testify under oath about this. So he will do everything possible to avoid testifying under oath.
And John, you know, Michael Cohen spokesman David Schwartz put out a statement in response to the president's comments, and he said, this is an accurate assessment of the facts. This is exactly what I have been saying all the way along. Michael Cohen made the payment to protect reputation, family, and business. It had nothing to do with the election. Now, of course, look, I think we all know full well that Michael Cohen would have expected to be paid back, right? But the president may not have known, to your point, right? May have been a general authority, and the president did never know about this specific payment. And Schwartz's argument is consistent. You know, here's what the news he broke on this with us last week on this show. Can you say unequivocally that the president was never in any way aware of the $130,000 or the agreement itself?
The president was not aware of the agreement. At least Michael Cohen never told him about the agreement. I could tell you that. And you asked a whole bunch of questions, so let me cover that.
Mm-hmm.
So you asked about 12 days before.
Not aware about the agreement. What about the money?
He was not aware about any of it. He was not aware.
Okay. Now, of course, this calls to brouhaha, John, because people said, well, if he wasn't aware, then that would mean the NDA itself is indeed invalid. Does anything the president said tonight change this?
I don't think anything changes. And I think Paul is correct in pointing out it's going to take a while for this to proceed. The federal judge is not going to expedite it. So this will just have to play out in its own time. And the question is whether it'll go to arbitration first and whether it'll get a chance to test the arbitration before it happens. So we're just inching a little bit along with this latest statement that could cause later jeopardy for the president. We'll see.
You know, John Dean will remember this, but what Trump needs here is what Nixon had when he was accused of having a slush fund that was used, and that was a dog named Checkers. And that got Nixon off the hook, but Trump doesn't have a dog. So I think the president is going to have a lot more trouble than Nixon.
Well, and of course, yeah, with the Clinton, you know, precedent, we shall see. You know, if he does get questioned by Bob Mueller, does this come up? Is this the sort of perjury issue that could cause a problem? Thank you both. And next, President Trump wants to send thousands of troops to the border to bolster.